met with a huge success, as although she has learned at the Dale Carnegie Institute in New York, she herself is a living proof of inner strength. We're all blessed with to become the best version of ourselves. So welcome, Sharon, and thank you very much for accepting to give us this talk today. Over to you.
Okay. Well, thank you, and good evening, everybody. And my agenda today is very simple. I find that everything in the world, we are born into conditioning, you know? 7 days a week, there are 24 hours in a day. You are 10 years old, 365 days make a year. And these are conditions that have been fed down to us ever since I can remember. Well, I am here to dispel that. I think you are as good as you feel. You should be able to rate yourself in your performance and your output as a parent, as a colleague in a company, as the CEO of a company. I was just doing a session, about an hour before our session, the one that we're doing now. And somebody told me that she says her whole life has been conditioned by people telling her, oh, you know, you're not quite good enough. So somebody says you're too fat, or somebody says you're too thin, or somebody says you're too old, somebody says you're too young. And these things form arrows in our heart. And these arrows form a wall, you know. So my friends, let's talk today about not playing victim anymore. Even Anita said 50 plus. I don't care whether you're 50 plus or 100 plus. How do you feel? How do you feel? And I'm not saying young or old. Do you feel healthy? Do you feel revitalized? Do you feel inspired? Do you feel active? And I think that should be your barometer to living your life, because life is a very precious thing, my friends. I mean, you know, I have made bad investments. I've lost that money, or I've cut my hair too short. And then I said, oh my God, what am I going to do? Or I wear the wrong color, or I've had the wrong relationship. And we can get out of all these things. But one of the things that we can't get out of is our life. Time is running, my friends. And it's a currency. How you choose to spend it is entirely up to you. There is nobody out there other than to tell you you're not good enough. This is what I've seen. And one of the things, sadly, I've noticed is that, I mean, I think the purpose of life is to be happy. But I really want to ask you, who do you have in your life who is really well and truly happy for your happiness and for your victory and for your success? I know in my case, I can count those people. Maybe my daughter, I don't know. So let's not start deciding, oh, you know, I'm old or I'm young. Let's talk about how we feel about life. And what do we want to do with this valuable currency that God has given us? You know, I'll never forget once I was talking to a priest, and he said, Sharon, when you pray, be innocent. Don't try and strategize with God. If you give me this, then I'll do that, and I hope this one. Don't strategize. And one of the biggest gifts that I have learned, my friends, is innocence. You know, at this stage of my life, I have to tell you that I am innocent. And when you're innocent, you're excited about life, because I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. And because you're innocent, you're not putting conditions on yourself that you can't do this and you can't do that. So I am setting up new companies. I'm bringing up companies for motivation modules. I'm wanting to, you know, sort of, I get loads of acting offers. Somebody said, do you want to invest in filmmaking? And nobody's saying, hey, you know what? You're not 20 or 30 years old. Nobody would dare talk to me and tell me that I'm not in the running of life, because you know what? I am in the running and I'm as good as everyone else. I have my attitude, I have my integrity, I have my ethics. And I don't have a choice, because there is nobody out there who is going to prop me up the mountain. I have a lot of people to pull me down, because that's life. There's society, there's your relatives, then there's the in-laws, there's competition in the market. There's... So if you're going to be pulled down by that, and then in addition you say, oh, well, you know, I'm over 40 or I'm over 50. I mean, you're a sinking boat, man. So I want to address with all of you, and I would love to have a heart-to-heart with as many of you to see what are the blockages, what is the traffic jam. We're driving a car and we've all decided we're going to get somewhere, obviously, because nobody gets into a car not to go anywhere. So similarly, you're in the car of your life and you're heading to a destination, and I presume you do have a destination, and that too is very important. You must have a mission in life. You were born not to just chill and hang and feel sorry for yourself or accept what life gives you. I mean, if you come home and, you know, and you wanted to have, I don't know, an egg curry, for example, and your family said, well, I'm sorry, there's only, there's only dal. Why would you accept that? As a lesson for myself, I have questioned the universe. I have challenged the universe. And I've never taken the ordinary route. To give you a small background, and I'm just going to talk for a few minutes because I'm very keen to remove the blockages, if at all there are any. I come from very humble beginnings. And my parents, you know, didn't have the money. We didn't have the food. We didn't have this. We didn't have that. But I did have a dream. And I knew, I said, I can sing. So as soon as I'm about 17 or 18, I want to get out of this atmosphere and go to Bombay and try my luck. Well, as luck would have it, and I'm going to cut the story very short, I was struck down by a disease. And guess what the disease was? What fun. My vocal cords got diseased. The one factor that I had, the one little bus ticket out of that hellhole, was my voice. And I lost it. To make matters worse, my parents didn't have the money. So they took me to some little chemist, a Vaid, as we call them in Delhi. And that guy said, look, if you don't take her to a hospital, she's going to die. And of course, my parents couldn't take me to a hospital because, well, we didn't have the money. So a couple of more months and I started getting sicker and sicker and sicker. And my mother took me back to this apothecary, as we called them in those days, a dispensary. And they kind of just made a small incision in my throat, and this illness just kept pouring out. So what happened was, and I'm trying to say this as fast as possible, I healed. My fever went down. I was no longer lying on my bed, groaning in pain. All that was fine. But I found that after 3 months, I couldn't talk. I couldn't speak. So I started, it was first very funny because I would start, can I have some tea or whatever? But I found in 3 months, I was still writing. So my mother took me back to this chemist, this dispensary. And I remember them telling her that, madam, we told you your daughter was going to die. So we have saved your daughter. So the good news is she's going to live. But the bad news is that her vocal cords are damaged and she's going to be dumb for the rest of her life. And I am so happy, my friends, that I got this huge roadblock in my life, because that is the day I decided that I was going to make the impossible possible. And I looked at the universe and I said, wow, you couldn't find somebody else your size? You had to give me all the problems, and that too at 17. And cut a long story short, I challenged the universe. I challenged the cosmic powers. I challenged whatever there was out there. And I'm walking and I'm standing tall today. Was my life full of obstacles? Absolutely. Were there problems? Totally. Did I make mistakes? Thousands. Did I sometimes land into a sand pit and climb out? Absolutely. But I am today, in my own way, living, but I have learned, live life on your own terms. And yet, if somebody had to say, Sharon, have you achieved everything? You know what I would tell them, even at this stage of my life? Honey, I'm just getting started. I've got another 20 more ideas. So I am enthused by the gift of life. My friends, we are alive. Somebody's asked me to speak louder. So hold on, let me see what I can do. Can I? Yeah, it's okay. So I'm going to try and talk a little louder. So I am grateful that I have the gift of life. And I am going to use this currency of life. And I am going to invest it wisely and create rich dividends for myself. For me, life is the biggest gift I have. And it's the one thing that will not, which doesn't increase. Money increases, your hair can grow, you can change the color of your clothes, you can change what you're going to eat. Life's going to keep running. So guys, winners or losers, what are we going to be? So I am now throwing the questions open to everybody in the house and saying, where are our mindsets? Are you living a life of fulfilled dreams? Are you not living a life of fulfilled dreams? Are you dealing with issues that are clouding your sunshine? Do you feel you're on top of the mountain, or do you feel you're at the bottom of the mountain and it's overwhelming? So let me get to understand you, because if you talk to me, then I can perhaps, you know, we can just open it up and we'll explore this journey for the next 40 minutes. So over to you all.
So anyone, if you want to ask any questions, please put it on the chat or unmute yourself. You can ask and then mute yourself.
I would
back
prefer
after
if
that.
They just unmute themselves and asked me a question.
Okay. Yeah,
Sharon,
so,
Sharon, I yes? wanted to ask you one thing, that when you had these problems, you had a strong support of your mom.
No.
Isn't it?
No.
No?
No. No.
Had she lost the hopes for your death? I mean, this in your life?
No. No, my parents were, my mother was too focused on finding food for us. My parents were going to accept this is God's wish. You have to understand, I did it without a support structure. And this is a very interesting question you're asking. You are your support structure, Bina.
Okay, okay.
Don't depend on anybody. The day you are a standalone, look at the tree outside your window. It's hit by storms and rain and sun, but a tree is a tree. We see very few trees falling unless they're felled down. You become the oak tree, and you will give shade to others rather than you looking for the tree and looking to hide underneath. If you switch that around, you will see how many gates open up.
Okay, no, because I realize that there are so many people in the family itself that they always pull you back and they don't allow you to go ahead. And being a lady in the family, sometimes you have been controlled by them.
Yes. So here's what I want to give you, because I've been dealing with this question a lot and I'm aware that this happens in most of our households. So the first thing you've got to do is I want you to take charge of your situation. First of all, I want you to look like a star in the house. Polish yourself, your weight, your hair, your clothing, your grooming. And if you read, whether it's the Mahabharata or the Vedas or books on Buddhism, you have to give before you can get. So without being subservient, I want you to lead by example. I want you to look at yourself as a star, but not a victim. I want you to run that household like Hitler, if you have to. You will create a vibration of order, of cleanliness. The food's on time. The curtains are dry cleaned. The sheets are washed. Beautiful meals are happening. And everybody will say, well, thanks to her, thanks to her, thanks to her. So I always say, give more than you get. Give more than you can get. And the day you do that, you will have people salaaming you, and you will, I'm sorry to put this bluntly, you will crush the competition, be it rivals in the home or in-laws or whatever. You see, as women, we have taken the sons away from their mothers. So whatever happens, you're looked on as a threat. You have to understand the psyche of in-laws. You are not a threat. You are a strength. You are a light. You are a Devi. You are a source of comfort. And if you, but you're not a victim. You're not a doormat. If you're a doormat, people will come and wipe their feet. All of us do that. If the doormat is outside, we will wipe our feet. No, we're not doormats. We are leaders. We're leaders of the home. We are professional, if I may call it, homemakers. Today, my home runs, I mean, I'm sorry to say, just things like the food that's being cooked, the sheets that are being cleaned, all that, it runs like a military camp. And the people around me have nothing but admiration for me. Now, once that's sorted, I'm free to live my dreams. So look into your life and say, if I was my own daughter-in-law, would I look up to you? And if the answer is no, improve that. You become the star in your family. Everything on point. And you are a comfort, and you are a strength, and you've spread laughter, and you've got cut flowers, and you're remembering the birthdays. Listen, we women don't have it easy. Being a homemaker is not easy, but you chose this life. You chose to be a homemaker. Now sparkle. Be sparkle after so many years. Why is there only one Amitabh Bachchan? Why is there only one Shah Rukh Khan? You become the Amitabh Bachchan of your home and you see what happens. But the buck begins and ends with you. Get your brand into position. I'm talking professionally. Put your brand in place and the audience will applaud. Till then, it's not going to happen.
It was really very good guidance.
Thank you. I've been this path. I've been through this path. So I know I had to become somebody that I wasn't, but that made me into the person that I am today. A person that adds value. A person that they come and run to, Sharon, we've got a problem. I was the most hysterical dithery person. Hai mera kya hoga? The doorbell would ring, I would jump. I didn't know how to sign a check. And I said, either I can live like a amoeba under a stone at the bottom of the sea, or I can be the sailboat who's going to skid across the oceans and let them all follow me. And I chose the latter. Next question.
That was
please.
Like super inspirational, Sharon. Yeah, that was like lovely. Anyone else? Anyone else would like to ask a question?
Hello, Sharon.
But yes, it is not.
Hello, this is Nirali.
Hi.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you. You said that you challenged the universe, right?
Yes.
Whatever you wanted to have from the universe, you challenged the universe. Can you be more specific about this?
So, when I was 17, no voice, no money, I actually sat down and I talked to the Hawa. I said, yaar, what is this? whatever I had, you've taken away from me, including my voice, which was going to be a hope for me. I said, I am not going to let you bully me. I am a fighter. I have not been born in this world to be a victim. I am not going to be a victim. Aap kuch bhi karo. I am not going to be a victim. I am the star of my film, of my life. I am the heroine. I am the producer. I am the director. Take it or leave it. So every time there was a roadblock, I would look at the roadblock and say, hello, roadblock. I have been expecting you. Aajao, aap bhi aajao, maro mujhe. And I have found that in all my, meditation helps. I'll be honest with you. I didn't want to actually digress to this, but meditation is a big part of my life. Why? Because meditation gives me clarity. And when you breathe and all your brain is oxygenated, your skin is oxygenated, my breathing, you can make out the energy that I have. This is all to do with meditation. But in meditation, I've got a lot of clarity. And I'm convinced now, I've actually, you know what? I've made friends with my problems. So when something wrong happens, like supposing, let's say Anita comes into my life. Sorry, Anita, I'm going to take your example. Okay. And Anita says, oh my God, Sharon, what is this? We were expecting this and we are disappointed. Understand? Now, I can choose to cry. I can choose to grumble about her. I can go to everybody saying, look at what Anita said. My life is finished. And I play the victim. Or I can say, wait a minute. What did Anita say? She said, I wasn't good enough. I was not ready. I was late. I was horrible or whatever. Maybe she's right. So when you get an obstacle in your way, don't back off. Look at the obstacle, because that is life teaching you to move to the next level. Otherwise, that obstacle will not come. And the more, I tell you something, my friends, I am not today here because of my victories. God has been kind. God has been kind. I'm here because of the mistakes I made. I'm sorry to put it bluntly, thanks to those mistakes, I'm smart. I learned finance. I learned investing. I've taken my degrees. I've set up a company, blah, 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 whatever it is. But if I didn't have the obstacles, I would be sitting in Delhi, my parents giving me, a little bit of khana, and we're all struggling, and chalo sab mil jhul ke, bichara beta, yehi hai, toh let's continue. No. I said, this is a problem. This is life telling me why settle for less. Embrace your problem. It is life telling you don't settle for this. You need to change. And I swear to you, if you look this problem, whether it's your relatives, whether it's money, whether it's a boss in the company, whether it's a COVID, look at it and say, life is teaching me a lesson. And I'm going to empower myself through this traffic jam. And good is going to come out of this. And if you do that every time, I've even seen people during the monsoons, we're walking down the road and suddenly somebody says, oh, damn, it's raining. Oh, my this, my that. I said, it's only water. Water is great for the skin. Let's hydrate our skins and let's just walk and get wet. Hello, rain, beautiful. And just enjoy the moisture and then walk home. Embrace your obstacles and you will become, you will get so many victories in your life, because you will say, bring it on, buddy. Bring it on, more problems. Okay, let's go for it. I hope that's answered your question.
I think that was wonderful.
Next question, please.
I think Rosmin has put her hands up. Rosmin, would you like to ask Rosmin, something?
Of course. Yes. Tell me, Rosmin. What a lovely name, Rosmin. Yeah.
Wow. Thank you, Sharon. Nice to see you. I've always admired your songs that Walter Woes and all those old songs, very nostalgic. Okay, the problem I'm facing is I'm been taken for granted by my own family, my husband, my relatives. So I feel something is wrong with me. I feel unloved and I admit I'm a little hot tempered, but then how to deal with the negativity all around?
Okay. So that's
I've
your
been
question.
Taken for granted by my kids also. They are grown up now.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, Rosemann, now you're seeing for yourself that you played the role of the victim, which was only one necklace, one bead on the necklace. And now you have formed a chain. And this is what happens. So now you have to start undoing this. And ladies, gentlemen, whoever's listening, but more really, this is for the ladies. You have to make yourself financially strong. You have to understand money. You cannot put doubts under the carpet. Oh, you know, my husband will look after it. Oh, my this. Oh, this will happen. So I would think, Rosemann, sit down and make a list of your strengths and all the areas that you can improve. Tell me, are you working?
No.
You're not working. Have you never worked?
Well, in a family business, I worked before. Mm-hmm. But now the business is no more. So I'm at home taking care of my father. Yeah.
Okay. So this is the garden that you're in. Think of yourself as the gardener. Okay. Because if you have given up a career to be the star of your home, then you need to absolutely manifest that. So whether you're looking after your aging in-laws, whether it's the maids, whether it's the food, whether it's this, the house has to resonate with your energy and your vibrancy, your look. Look like a star. Look a little glamorous. Tidy up. Get the grooming situation. I can't see where you look like. Where are you, Rosemann? I'm trying to.
Oh, my video is off because.
Okay, no problem.
I'm
1 minute.
Not dressed. Yeah.
I understand. Don't worry. I'm sorry. The phone fell. I am not going to try and do that again. Just hold on a second. So I'm going to be very vague, very, very, sorry, just one. Let me just try and adjust this properly. Hold on. Let me, this thing. Ha. So 1 minute. Where are you on Zoom? Hold on. There we are. Okay. So I want you to take care of your appearance. I want you to look like a star. It's like one of the examples that I always use is supposing you were going into a hospital, to get one of your, God forbid, a family member operated. You're spending a lot of money. You go and meet the doctor, and the doctor sitting in shorts and a topi on his head, as if he was sun tanning in Goa. Would you trust him? Appearances are very important. Appearances are very important.
Yeah, no.
So the first thing is I want you to look the part. I want you from tonight, whether it's a facial, whether it's a face scrub, whether it is your hair, I want you to look gorgeous.
Okay.
And I want you, somebody has messaged from Nilima, husband's, yes, I get it. Let's also address the finance part of it. You have to give to get. If I was sitting in front of you and I was in my night suit and I said, please, I don't want to show my face on Zoom because I'm not groomed. That wouldn't be perfect. So not only am I groomed, not only am I on camera, but I'm also groomed. Because the idea is to impress you. And the idea is to get your respect. And the first thing that happens first impression, last impression. If I look good, I've then got my foot through the door. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I want you, my dear Rosemann, to take your grooming into control. I want the family to say, wow, mom's looking great. Tomorrow, I want you to go and rip the kitchen down and I want you to make it sparkling. I want you to go into the drawing room and get a bottle of air freshener, plump up the cushions, the carpets, put fresh flowers, open up the windows, make the house sparkle like a movie set. And turn it around. I want you to surprise them with a, when is the last time you surprised them with a beautiful dish? Maybe some fresh salad, maybe some gluten-free bread, maybe a keto diet, maybe a gluten-free cake. There are 1,000 ways of winning respect from your family. Respect is earned. Respect is a very simple thing. Rosemann, listen, we've got to be smart, okay? Yes. If I want something from you and you're selling, then I have to have the money to buy it. You're not going to give it to me free.
Yes.
So you're going to buy those people. You're going to buy their respect. 10 rupiah yaha, 20 rupiah yaha. And get your maids in your house, your chutta kambai, your security, everything. I want your house to be the most fabulous house in the building.
Yes.
And I want you to look. I want you to look the part. If you feel good, it will show.
Okay.
I don't want you to think like you're a victim. I don't want you to look like you're a victim. Respect yourself, dear. Respect yourself. Be beautifully groomed first thing in the morning. Be ready to greet everybody. Maybe small things, you know, little changes. And I'll tell you what, you know, when I performed, I remember Shamak and me were talking. And we did a show once and the audience applause is a little cold. So Shamak came to me and said, yeah, Sharon, this is damn discouraging, man. We tried so hard. And, you know, the audience didn't respond. So we went to one of our elder people who were, you know, in the play, they were playing our parents and all that. And this is a guy called Farooq Mehta. And Farooq said, Sharon, did you do your best? I said, Farooq, I gave my life on the stage. He says, you really gave your life? I said, I absolutely did my best. He said, then leave it. So first you do your best. So now I don't care. My idea is irrespective of the end result, even of the seminar. I am going to do my best. I am going to do my best. I am going to be a beacon of light in my home. I am going to respect myself so that when I walk into the bedroom or the drawing room or the kitchen, people know that the madam of the house has improved. Do it for yourself. Thank you for all the inputs I'm getting. Yes, anybody wants to join in, can I would love all your inputs. No need to WhatsApp me. Let's all help Rosemann become the star of her movie. So respect yourself. Be ready. Look good, feel good. And if you feel good from the inside, it will reflect on the outside.
What about the outsiders, Sharon? What about the outsiders? This is of the family, right? What about relatives and cousins and all those? I'm always taken for granted. Okay. Yeah.
Can I tell you very bluntly?
Yes.
So here's what I'm going to tell you, which is very wrong of me to say this, but I can't think of a better example because we're limited with time. Okay. If Mukesh Ambani had to walk into your drawing room, do you think he'd really care about what this one is thinking and that one is thinking and this one is thinking? He's Mukesh Ambani. Okay. If you are a star in your life as a mother, as a wife, as a daughter-in-law, as a neighbor, you do your job and forget about, you cannot please everybody. People will turn around. And if they don't, too bad. Tell me, do these relatives support you financially?
No.
Forget it then, the matter is over.
Okay.
Forget it, walk tall. Walk tall, stop playing victim to non-existent people for a little bit of non-existent little thali. If the thali is going to get you crores of rupees, come to me personally and I'll tell you what to do. But if you're not getting anything out of it, Forget it. Make sure that you're a great host when they come. Make sure that you carry yourself so well that your husband says nice things about you. You see, once the rain falls in the garden, that's when the moistness comes and the flowers start blooming. You be the rainfall right now. Be the example. That's what Malhala said. I want to be the example. You be the example and the rest will follow. But this is the first step.
Thank you so much.
You have to get your act together. It's not going to come to you. Nothing comes to you, not even a lottery. We're all self-made people, Rosemann. You want it, make it. You want to eat rice, cook it. Rice is not going to walk out of the stove and come to you magically. Nothing, there's no magic formula. You want it, make it, do it, be it, act it.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks, Sharon. That was wonderful. Padmini has her hand raised for quite some time.
Padmini, what can we do for you? I hope I have an answer. Go ahead, dear. Padmini,
you're on mute, Padmini. Padmini, you're on mute. You're on mute.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. No, first of all, I wish everybody happy Women's Day. And yay. I would like to share one or two things. We should first love ourselves.
Absolutely.
And we should respect ourselves. That's the first thing. Secondly, exactly. Monetarily, we should be stable. And thirdly, we should be physically fit. Then we have more confidence in ourselves and we can work wonders, ma'am. That's all.
Padmini, that was excellent. And that's another thing, Rosemann and everybody else. Look after your health. I'll tell you in my case, I have given up white sugar and I've given up wheat. And I feel wonderful. I take my vitamins. I don't do a lot of exercise because I don't have the time. But a little bit of yoga, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I have given up wheat. I have given up white sugar. I cheat once in a while. But on a daily basis, a little bit of care on my diet. I think eating the correct foods is very important. And so that's one thing that Padmini was saying. So if you want your skin and your hair and your vitality to radiate. I mean, honestly, I don't know whether you will agree with me, but I don't eat chapatis. I don't eat chapatis. I don't eat parathas. I don't eat bread. I don't eat butter. I mean, I have dal ka chillas, you know, which have replaced my chapatis. Tonight, I'm going to have a biryani, but the menu is very selective. Lots of water. Lot of emphasis on health, and obviously there's no alcohol and smoking and all that because you know you can't cut it at both ends. And I'm sorry, somebody was asking me a question about sons and daughters. So look after your health, and yes, I think finance is very important, ladies, gentlemen. You know, I would think, gentlemen, if you're married to women who you have not financially empowered, I would humbly request you, please put a little money into their banks and teach them how to handle a fixed deposit and enjoy the dividends as a blessing. I don't know why we women are kept so isolated from our money, particularly women who have given up their careers to be homemakers. I think they deserve a little bit of financial independence so that they can spend without saying, can I have 5,000 rupees or can I have 2,000? And if the men can do this, it would be wonderful. I get you, Nilima. At this age, we can't earn. I don't know how old you are. And of course, you can earn, but that's an attitude. But I think you need your men's cooperations. And if you can convince them to help you invest and understand finance, and those of you who are working, I suggest you become financially savvy. I did by default after wrong investments and wrong jobs and this and that. And today I handle my finances independently. And I'm not saying that I have millions, but what I have, at least I'm guarding it like a watchdog. And somebody else said, at this age, we're dependent on our sons and daughters. What age are all of you that you're dependent on your sons and daughters? May I have an idea?
Sunit Bhatnagar, I think that was from you.
Yes.
Can we have you on your video or Sunit? You can unmute yourself and talk.
I am 65, madam.
You are 65 and?
No, but I was saying all the ladies, I think they are, sorry, I have not to say their age, but all are maximum, they are plus 60.
Okay.
So nowadays, madam, if you see in the metro cities, most of the guardians, parents are staying with their children or children are thrown away them to in the old age home. Is okay. It possible that a lady or a mother send make up herself and change the complete drawing room, dining room, other things? Is it possible nowadays without any financial support?
I didn't understand the question.
What he says, Sharon, is that he's saying, like, since the ladies who now, I mean, the older they grow, they're dependent on their children. So he says they really wouldn't have the finances to do like so much of changes in their life.
Correct.
No, I understand that. So the thing is that you have to add value to the status quo. What do I mean by that? As aging parents, if I may use that word, you know, we are the liability. We are in that, oh my God, we've given my mother the bedroom. But age is just a number. Why do we behave as if we're old? Be youthful. You know, yes, you're dependent on your children. No problem with that. Build a nice, healthy, radiant relationship. So why does dependency have to become a burden? I want you to twist things so beautifully around that people say, oh my God, thank God my mother's with me. Because parents are a huge asset to the youngsters who can then continue their careers. I mean, a lot of us, I would have wished my mother was with me to help me when I was bringing up my daughter. I would have given anything to have my mother with me. So look at yourself as a blessing. Why are you looking at yourself like a sinking ship? Run
absolutely
the house, set up the house, be happy, become the strength, take your children for a walk, bring them back, let the children go out and earn, and they will say, Mom, Dad, thank God you all are here. At least my child will not get hurt. I know I can go away for 10 days. Do you know, my daughter, I still can't leave for 10 days. I can't. I don't have the infrastructure. You people are so blessed. I don't want you to become a curse. Be a blessing. The world needs parents in the house. Have you understood that? Become of value. The world needs you. Look after your parents. Look after your children. Look after your grandchildren. They will be touching your feet every day saying, Dad, I can conquer the world because you're in the house with me. And somebody has said, why should we become nannies? Now, hold on. If you have chosen to be homemakers and protect your children and their children, then you are homemakers. That's a choice that you made. And if you can put an infrastructure into place where you've got the maids, you've got this, you've got that, and you are the pilot of this ship. So here's how it works. You're the head of the house. You've got staff, you've got this, you've got that. Everybody runs thanks to your systems. Your children can go out and start earning. They can take transfers. They can work. They can have late hours because you are there. And there are your grandparents, your grandchildren, who know that no harm can come to me because Nana and Nani are there. So call yourself a nanny. I would say, my God, you're a diamond in the house. Treat yourself like a diamond. Run the house with strength and courage. And somebody said, why should we don roles? No, can you talk to me because I'm not understanding your question. Nayantara? I don't agree. Yes. Actually.
Yes, Sharon ma'am, why should we be mothers or wives or daughters and play the dutiful role? Can't we live for ourselves? Why should we explain to them? Why should we explain to our children?
1 minute, okay. 1 minute.
I'll take care of your children. You take care of me. I don't understand that.
But my dear, you are living in a society, you're living in a shell where everybody is playing their part. If your son and daughter are out earning, your maids are doing their part, you are the caretaker. But I'll tell you what you have to do. You have to become a woman of today's generation. You must understand computers. You must be technically proficient. You don't want to be that sweet little bundle locked up in a little room saying, listen, I'm ready to go, I'm happy. That's not right. I don't have an answer for you. Because you have to be a winner. Run your home. You've married somebody. You've given birth to people. They have run a home. They've called you into their home to live with them. And now you say, why should I look after them? Embrace the challenge. I understand that looking after children is a 24-hour job. It's a huge responsibility. But I want you to look at it differently. Set up a system where people work for you and with you, and you are running the show. Because in a car, the brake does its job, the accelerator does its job, the steering wheel does its job, the AC does its job, and that's how the car moves. And as somebody who's older than everybody, you set up the system. Like the other day, I was just telling... I just spoke to my daughter the other day, and I live with my daughter, and I said, you know what? I'm getting a little tired because it's a little bit of a late night, so I'm going to tweak the timings around on food and whatever. And she said, what a great idea. So we are now revamping our system, and that's when you have an intelligent talk to your children and say, look, I'd like to set up a schedule where everybody does their bit, and I'd like to try it for a week, and let's see whether it works. And when you put that out intelligently, everybody will listen. In my household, everybody listens to me. My daughter has a flourishing career. I have maids, I have relatives come and stay, but by God, nobody messes with me because I have set up the systems. I'm not saying, oh, poor old me, I've done all this, and forget it, I'm ready. I'm going to set up a system that we can all coexist in harmony. And that has to be the agenda, I'm afraid. You can't coexist in isolation. You can't do that. Coexist in harmony, doing your bit. Yes, I think Rakesh wants to ask a question.
So Rakesh, he wants to share something. Rakesh, yes, you can go ahead.
Ma'am, main Hindi mein bolunga.
Anji, please, zarur boliye.
Happy Women's Day.
And to you, sir.
So retirement जैसे मेरा हुआ, wife का मेरा हो जाएगा, मैं तो retired हूँ. तो financially इस time पे मेरी बहुत अच्छी है, कोई problem नहीं है financials में.
माशाल्लाह.
तो but ये जो क्या बोलते हैं life cycle है बच्चों का, उनका है कि रात को जागते हैं, सुबह सोते हैं.
Okay.
तो हम लोग तो क्या बोलते हैं रात को जल्दी सोने वाले हैं और सुबह जल्दी उठने वाले हैं.
जी.
तो उससे ये कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होता है कि बच्चे कहते हैं हमें टाइम नहीं देते.
ओके.
अगर रात को देर तक जागते हैं तो हमारी तबीयत खराब हो जाती है.
अच्छा, लेकिन मैं कुछ पूछना चाहती हूँ आपको बहुत जल्दी. ये आप अपने बच्चों के साथ रहते हो?
हाँ जी, हाँ जी.
अच्छा, लड़के हैं, लड़कियां हैं?
डॉटर्स तो मैरिड है और बेटा मेरे साथ ही है.
अच्छा, तो कौन लेट आ रहा है?
नहीं, अब बच्चे तो क्या बोलते हैं जैसे रात को तो जागते हैं और सुबह सोते हैं.
नहीं, सर, आप कह रहे थे एक लड़का है आपके घर में. ये जो आप शायद फरमाइश कर रहे हो, पेश कर रहे हो, ये किसके बारे में आप बात कर रहे हो?
मैं तो बेटी की तो शादी हो गई, बेटे के बारे में बात कर रहा हूँ. तो बेटा जो है रात को जागता है, मैरिड है ना, वो रात को जागता है, सुबह सोता है वो.
ओके. और क्या काम करता है?
वो एक यूएस कंपनी में प्रोजेक्ट एसोसिएट है, मैनेजर है, प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर।
वेरी गुड,
नोएडा में है।
अच्छी कमाई है उनकी?
हाँ, अराउंड 1 लाख पर मंथ।
ओके, और कंपनी में भी उनकी इज्जत है?
बहुत ज्यादा इज्जत है, लेकिन जो जब ग्रेडिंग होती है, परफॉर्मेंस में कुछ मिलता है तो उसमें कट कर देते हैं।
नहीं, मतलब उनकी उनका करियर अच्छा चल रहा है ना?
हाँ हाँ।
ओके सर, आप मेरी बात सुनिए
जी।
आपके बेटे के पास इंटरनेशनल जॉब है। मेरे कई क्लाइंट्स हैं जो इंटरनेशनली अभी के लिए उन्होंने जो दे आर ऑन अमेरिकन टाइम, अमेरिका का तो 12 घंटा आगे है ही।
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, वही प्रॉब्लम है। तो
आप कुछ नहीं कर सकते इसमें, आप
हाँ
जी,
बच्चों को टाइम कैसे दे? बच्चे कहते हैं 5 दिन काम करते हैं तो हमें आउटिंग चाहिए 2 दिन, शनिवार और इतवार को, तो हमारे साथ तो बैठने की बात
है। तो आई एम सॉरी टू से कि वो तो आपका प्रॉब्लम है नहीं। बच्चे, ये लड़का, मेरे पास कई लोग हैं इंटरनेशनल बैंकिंग में जो रात को सोते नहीं है, और अभी के लिए दिस इज अ फेज, एक ये एक फेज है, ये फेज भी चली जाएगी। बट अगर आपके लड़के के पास इंटरनेशनल जॉब है और उनकी मार्केट्स खुलती हैं रात को, काम करने दीजिए। तब वो सैटरडे सर
सैटरडे संडे को अपनी फैमिली में बिजी रहता है, इन लॉज के पास चले गए, आउटिंग में चले गए, नाइट पार्टी चाहिए।
तो आप अपनी जिंदगी जियो, इनको अपनी जिंदगी जियो भाई, एक बगीचे में।
उनको टाइम कैसे देंगे?
आपकी जिंदगी जियो, आप आपकी जिंदगी जियो, बच्चों को
छोड़ो, आप अपनी जिंदगी जियो सर।
उनको टाइम देना चाहते हैं मैम।
अरे भाई साहब,
ये उल्टा बोल रहे हैं।
उनकी उम्र है अपने दोस्तों के साथ एंजॉय करना, आप समझते? ऑफकोर्स मेरी बेटी का भी ये फेज था, रात पिक्चर्स देखते थे, कुछ नहीं, इट्स ओके। हाँ जी, हाँ, सॉरी,
समबडी सेड समथिंग, समबडी हैड टू से समथिंग।
आई थिंक उनको खुद के लिए, खुद को, बच्चों को उनके लिए टाइम नहीं, उसकी ये है प्रॉब्लम।
लेकिन मैं टाइम देना चाहता हूं मैम उनको।
नहीं होगा,
आप टाइम नहीं, आप उनका टाइम नहीं देना चाहते।
आपके बच्चों की ये उम्र है कि वो अपने लिए लाइफ जिए, उनको प्लीज जीने दीजिए। आप अपना काम कीजिए, अपने टीवी देखिए, आप अपने वाइफ के साथ वॉक के लिए चले जाना, आप लोग अपना ग्रुप बना लेना, लाफ्टर क्लब जो भी है। आपके बेटे को आप छोड़ दीजिए, और आप खुद बच्चे थे जब आप छोटे थे, जितना आपके माँ बाप ने नाना बोला, आप माने उनके बात नहीं? मेरे डैडी बोलते थे इस टाइम आ जाओ, सोते थे, मैं खिसक जाती थी, मैं उस्ताद थी भाई। जितना आप बोलोगे कि ये चूर्ण मत खाइए, आपका गला खराब होगा, उतना वो खाएंगे। आप उनको छोड़ दीजिए, आपके लड़के के पास है, वो काम कर रहे हैं, इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में काम कर रहे हैं, उनको सोने दो, उठने दो, उठने दो, सोने दो। आप प्लीज प्लीज जस्ट टेक द प्रेशर ऑफ हिम, वो आज आपका बेटा है भैया, कहीं नहीं जाने वाला। मैंने अपने मम्मी डैडी, I mean now in fact I tell people that I was a nightmare daughter. If my parents said you can't do it, वो अब मैं तो निकल पड़ी, and I turned out okay. Just let it go. जितना आप बोलोगे सो जाओ सो जाओ सो जाओ, वो बहुत पुराने जमाने की पेरेंटिंग है, लीव इट, लेट हिम लिव।
हाँ ठीक है, जी जी,
प्लीज जस्ट बैक ऑफ।
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Sharon. That was like absolutely an amazing session. I mean, I'm sure we have not had something like that positive and that confident like you just gave it to us today in this session. Absolutely fantastic. Loved every moment of it. And thank you all of you who attended this session, and hope to see you again soon with Sharon also on this platform. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much. Thank you, and bye-bye.
Thank you.
Happy Women's Day.
Happy Women's Day to everybody.
Live your lives. Just live your lives. Don't worry about sons, daughters. This is not the age to do it. Do your thing. Become the star of your movie, which is your life. Bye.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.